So what's in my bookcase? I would love to show you. But first, I gotta build it.
Imagine it never happened. Imagine no rapping. Imagine niggas trapped. Imagine and having action. Imagine how these niggas could be acting if we never got this shit cracking. Imagine life so hard, you can't imagine. It's like living in the city of God, you feel me? Imagine life from the yard, or trying to get that dollar on some shitty ass job. Imagine Biggie with his son. Imagine Pop getting called Pop by one. Imagine a mother struggling, dealing with a system that don't give a fuck about who shot her son. Imagine life where you can't win, when you get out the ghetto and go right to the pen. When you get out the pen, you go right to the gym. So if you get back to the streets, you go right back in.
So as you can see, it's finished. And I don't have that many books right now in the bookcase because most of my books are still in storage. Now that I at least have this up, I've got some room for some of my books. So I can get them out and I can put them up. There really isn't any kind of rhyme or reason to how I put this stuff in the shelf. Top shelf is mostly kind of like film and writing related. Save the Cat books. I really do like Save the Cat, so I got Save the Cat books up there. Adventures in the Screen Trade by William Goldman, which is a classic. Stephen King's On Writing, which is the best book. The absolute best book on writing that's out there. And then I have my my clapboard, which is cool, I think. On the second shelf, you know, just some more books. You know, I got a couple of my books, Guest List and Orange Mound, Reclaiming Our Space, written by Feminista Jones. Got a collection of Baldwin novels. It's a singular volume. And then a photo of myself when I was on the Sony Pictures studio tour. Got Black Mamba from Aquaman, the Genie from Aladdin. Got a Billy Ray Valentine Funko Pop. So presently, yeah, that's what's in my bookcase.